Number seven, this is where I'm putting Gronk. I really didn't want to put him on this list, but I almost didn't want to leave him off of it just because of the potential. I mean, he retired last year. He's a Hall of Fame tight end, without a doubt. He comes back after having a year off, having the rapport that he has with Tom Brady. And I don't even think you're going to see an inkling of O.J. Howard in this offense. So it's all based on potential. Who knows how he's really going to fare? If he is really healthy, if his conditioning and endurance is really there. But he is one of the best tight ends, one of the top 10 best tight ends ever in the history of the NFL. So I don't think you can sleep on him. I don't think that's anything that you should do, but you also shouldn't have him too high. Like, you can't rank him in the top five or the top three or anything like that, which a lot of people are. You have to tamper your expectations when it comes to Gronkowski, but you also can't sleep on him. So I think top 10 is fair for him, but don't expect top five production.
Oh, man. He could do well. But there's just so many question marks because they have two, like, all-pro caliber wide receivers. And then they have
And that's the problem, because where someone's going to get left out of that offense, out of these guys that we're going to talk about, so you just don't know who it's going to be. But I have a feeling it's not going to be Gronk, because he's coming out of retirement for Tom, you know, to do this. So
go ahead. I can't wait for this conversation on the receiver side.
But
I know.
I think all your points are fair. But then there's also two really good wide receivers or tight ends in Cameron Bray and O.J. Howard. I agree that O.J. Howard is not going to get the touches, and I'm surprised that the Bucks haven't tried. Maybe they have tried to trade him, and they just haven't been able to find a buyer for him. But he's not going to have a role in this offense. You compound that with the fact that Bruce Arians doesn't use tight ends. Like, they're not featured in his offense. So Tom Brady may have a rapport with Gronk, but there might just not be the opportunity. On top of that, Gronk is as good a blocker as he is a receiver, and so that may really appeal to Bruce Arians to put him on the field. Somebody is going to take him in the first six rounds, and in our league, that person's name is Rob.
I was going to say that. I was like, I'm glad. I don't need to worry about it at all, luckily, because Rob Schneider will draft him. So
We're all thinking it.
No, it's a good point, because, like, you're like, if you're not going to take him high, you're not going to get him. So if you're not high on Gronk, don't worry about it. To me, the real question is, what do you do with Cameron Brate? Because I think Cameron Brate is a real talent and might get the bulk of the catches in that offense. But again, to circle back to your point, Mike, Tom Brady and Rob Gronkowski have a rapport. How far does that extend? If you're really optimistic about it, then yeah, absolutely he's worth the top 10 pick. If you're concerned about all the other options, Tom Brady being in a new system for the first time, Gronk coming out of retirement and being, you know, 100 pounds lighter than he was, then I personally am just going to stay away from him.
Sure. Yeah, I have deep concern about Gronkowski's weight, first and foremost. Yeah. But if there's one thing about Tom Brady, it's he will only throw to you if he connects with you on a mental level. And we don't know that yet about any of the other players he's playing with, but him and Gronk have been a problem for the league for 8 years. And I don't for a second believe that he's not going to be a receiving threat. I do have him at number five. So I just don't see a circumstance where Brady doesn't mention it if it's half Brady's offense. And Gronk is a rare talent. He could put on weight. I don't know, or play differently, but I think he's just a freak, and we'll make it work.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I've been wrong before. I mean, not often, because I've won the league four times in the last 7 years, but I have been wrong. So maybe I am.